The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network. I'm not afraid, to take a stand.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Thursday afternoon. I trust and hope that you are doing well. If you want to give us a call on the show today, here are the numbers to do so. You can call us on 323-6232. That's 323-6232 or 325-4316, 325-4316 or 325-4259, 325-4259. You can text us on 422-4796, that's 422-4796, or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. We are live on Cable Bahamas, channel 969. That's the way my mother listens to the show, or you can catch us on BTC Flow channel 612. That's BTC Flow Channel 612. So I know that former Minister of Immigration, National Security, the Honorable Loftus Roker, urges stronger action on immigration. I know that. I know that that a sloop carrying about 100 Haitians landed in South Andros. I know that too. I know that. I know that there are continuous discussions going on about immigration and what ought to be done about it. I know that that is true. And I know that the government has been blasted by the leader of the opposition for a late fiscal report. So I know all those things. And I'm happy if you have a query or question or comment about it to talk about. But that's not the highest priority I have today for a discussion with you. Because I have a question for you. Do teachers matter? Do teachers, the people who teach your children in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas, do they matter? I mean, really, honestly, does it matter if we have them, don't have them? Does it matter if they do a good job, don't do a good job? If they, you know, are motivated, not motivated? If their morale is high, not high? Does it matter? Do we really care? Do we care about teachers? Do we care about teachers? Right? Less than an hour ago, I participated in a press conference held at the Ministry of Education, led by the Honorable Glynis Mahana Martin, at which an improving teacher morale implementation committee was being announced. Improving Teacher Morale Implementation Committee was being announced at that press conference. To be honest with you, the government of the Bahamas and the Minister of Education and the Ministry of Education are doing some foundational things in education. At least two things of which I am fully aware, right? For example, last year, the Minister of Education, the government of the Bahamas, signed an agreement with the University of the Bahamas' Government and Public Policy Institute to undertake a two-year study. The study will take 2 years. What is that study? The study has asked researchers to identify the factors that are impacting student learning outcomes in the Bahamas. So this is foundational because for the first time, there is going to be merely a guess at it or, you know, some opinionating at it. But researchers are being asked to provide evidential support for what it is that is producing the learning outcomes that we have in the Bahamas. Now, learning outcomes don't just relate to children's academic competence. So the study won't just look at the grades that students have, though they will be looked at. Why are the grades the way they are? Why are they the way they are in any particular subject? Why are they the way they are in any particular school? Why are they the way they are in any particular region, any particular socioeconomic group maybe? So why are the grades the way they are? But not only academic competence, but character issues, because that's a part of the learning outcome also that the medication seeks to produce. Students with the ability to be employable, to be sociable, to be civil, and those kinds of things. So now you have to go and see what are the factors impacting that. The research does not come to the table presumptuous. It doesn't come to the table to say, yeah, we already know this is the case. No. The research must look at the data, must do the work, and then see what the evidence says is the case. Whether that has to do with teacher factor, home factor, community factors, leadership factors, all kinds of factors that might be impacting on those learning outcomes. That was commissioned by the government of the Bahamas, the Minister of Education, Glenys Anna Martin, last year. The work is in earnest on it started in November, December, really. Right? So it's a fresh study being undertaken. So that's the first. It's foundational. It is really a seminal work being undertaken for the Ministry of Education, from which then recommendations can come as to how to improve, or maybe even where it is high, continue learning outcomes identified. That's the first thing. The other thing that the government of the Bahamas, the Minister of Education, did was to ask the question, what does it take to improve teacher morale in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas? What does it take? And so sometime in early 2022, around about January or thereabouts, a committee was formed to look at teacher morale and the things impacting teacher morale in the Bahamas. That committee did its work up to June of last year, and then produced a report of its findings for the government, and then submitted that report along with recommendations to the government for how it might address the issue of teacher morale. one of the things that, two things that the committee did, again, in keeping with sound examination of a problem, was the committee said, you know, this issue might be an issue that others have addressed, have looked at. So it said, how can we see what the existing research out there says about this issue? And so the Government and Public Policy Institute at the University of the Bahamas undertook a literature review of the issue of teacher morale and teacher motivation, examined a vast body of literature from the locally, from the region, internationally, to see what they said about this issue of teacher morale and teacher motivation, and gave those findings to the committee, from which the committee then, which the committee then used to consider its work. That's the first thing. The committee also said, listen, notwithstanding what we may learn from the literature, notwithstanding what we may ourselves think and believe or know, because there were many educators, people with education background on the committee, the committee also said, let's hear from the teachers. Let's hear from the teachers. So let's do a survey and ask the teachers, are they motivated? Is their morale high? What is impacting their motivation? What is impacting their morale? What do they think needs to be done about it? And so You Matter, We Care survey was sent out, and hundreds of teachers responded. Listen, over 700 teachers responded, which means that when you consider the number of teachers in the public education systems in particular, that is a humongous sample. Humongous sample, right? Think about this. Think about it this way. In America, a scientific sample might have 300 people in it. And the population of America is over 300 million. And they use that sample to ascertain views about the American public, so long as it's a random scientific sample. Similarly, here we have a couple thousand teachers, maybe about 5,000 teachers or thereabouts. You have a 700 person sample. That's huge, right? Okay. So, interestingly enough, from that survey, teachers said themselves, this is not what the Ministry of Education says. This is not what the government says. This is not what the Teacher Morale Committee says. The teacher says, 70% plus teachers said, we're motivated. Our morale is high. We love our work. We enjoy our work. 80%+. But 15%+ said, we don't feel appreciated. We have issues with a number of things, and they reveal those things so that the committee then was able to inform itself so that in its recommendations, it could take on board what teachers actually said. And so what the minister did was to take the report, it was a 101-page report, to the cabinet with the recommendations, and the cabinet endorsed the recommendations. And now what the Ministry of Education is doing is it's taken the report and the recommendations, formed the implementation committee consisting of a number of the people on the morale committee that did the original report, to go ahead and implement, see about the implementation of the recommendations. So I'm going to do a couple of things today. I'm going to talk to you about what the literature review said about teacher morale and what teachers said about their morale, and also talk to you about the recommendations that the committee provided, and then to ask you what you think. Do teachers matter? And do we care? You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break.
I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather.
With so much going on in the world today, only accepting cash at your business can be risky. Let Fidelity offer you and your customers safety, convenience, and the flexibility of a fixed or mobile terminal. Take it with you, on the move and on the go, because business should never stop. For more details, speak to one of our business development officers at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport. Visit our website at fidelitygroup.com or visit us at any of our branches.
Always on the go? Miss the show? You can now listen to Guardian Radio talk shows anytime, anywhere on Spotify and YouTube by searching Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or by entering the name of your favorite show. You can also listen by logging on to guardiantalkradio.com and clicking on the podcast tab. Guardian Radio, continuing to provide you with fresh news and smart talk anywhere, anytime, all day.
Babe! You mashed the car?
I ain't mashed the car. The lady who ran into me mashed the car.
I hope she had insurance.
If she had insurance, she hop out, pull out her phone, pull up the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang, she was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
I'm not afraid to take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Thursday afternoon. If you want to give us a call, the numbers are 323-6232 or 325-4316 or 325-4259. You can text us on 422-4796 or you can WhatsApp us on 439-3043. So, an examination of the issue of teacher motivation and teacher morale using the existing body of some of it, of literature out there. You know, one of the things that's clear is your morale and your motivation are not the same things. When we talk about your motivation or teacher's motivation or my motivation, we're talking about the what drives you to meet your needs, right? So that's your motivation. Like, how driven are you to meet your needs? So we all have need to have our basic survival requirements met, like food and shelter and that kind of safety. So that kind of thing. So we all motivated to do that. That's why you get up and you eat. That's why you go to work. Because basically you're trying to meet those basic needs. And so you're driven to do that. Now, some people are less driven, and that's why they stay home and they hang out and they, you know, they aren't going to do all that's necessary to get a job or to start a business in order to meet those needs, because they're not that motivated, right? But others are motivated. For some people, they are not motivated because those things are being met by other people so easily. So motivation speaks to your pursuit of your drive and how driven are you in that pursuit. So if you're highly motivated, you are driven, really driven, and you're going to go, you're going to kick down doors, and you're going to jump over hurdles, and you're going to knock down barriers, and you're going to deal with who you have to deal with in order to get it done. Some of you in your lifetime, let me tell you something, your money issues, your health issues, your relationship issues, my health issues, relationship issues, etc., reflect nothing but our motivation. We're not driven enough. We don't see, maybe these things aren't seen as a part of some fundamental need we have. And so we're not motivated and we don't get as much done. Other people are so driven. They'll stay up late at night. They get up early in the morning. They'll walk, run, push. They'll crawl if they have to do it because they really want to get those needs met. So that's motivation. Morale is different. Morale is about the attitude you have toward what you do, right? How confident are you about what you do? How passionate are you about what you do? How celebrated do you feel about what you do? How appreciated do you feel about what you do? That's different. That's what morale is. And so that is about some of those internal forces in your heart and head that in you feel good about what you are. So I can ask you, what's your morale like about your personal development? Is it high? Meaning, are you really confident about it? Are you really feeling good about it? Are you really, passionate about it? I could ask you what your morale is in your relationship, whether with your significant other or spouse or with your colleagues or friends or partners. So you could ask, what's your morale like in that respect? What's your morale like about finances and so forth? So morale is about the sense of wellness, a sense of contentment, a sense of feel good about what you have. And so the literature tells us that we make those two distinctions between whether teachers are motivated, as in driven to meet their needs, on how their morale is in terms of how they feel about the work that they do. According to the survey, listen to me, those of you who like to opinionate, according to the survey by those teachers, most teachers are both motivated and have elevated morale about their work, which one of the members of the committee said to me, Pastor Knowles said to me, Reverend Knowles, he said, you know what? They are digging deep in themselves about this work. So regardless of the outside stuff, in their heart of hearts, they still feel good about the work. And I was like, wow, true. So we know that. We also know from the literature that you don't approach the issue of teacher motivation and teacher morale simplistically, that it is a multifaceted, complex issue, and that it has many things at play and many things at play interrelatedly that is impacting upon teacher motivation and morale. But interestingly, the literature says that while there may be different things impacting motivation and morale, the solutions to both motivation and morale tend to be about the same. It is about improving teacher working conditions, improving the workload of teachers so that they don't feel overloaded by the work and suffer burnout. They need to have students that are motivated and are disciplined and that can cooperate with them in the teaching exercise. That they need to avoid aggression against themselves by teachers and parents, students and parents. That they need to have some control in their local environment as to what they teach and how they teach, and they have the authority to manage their classroom and the students in it, that they need to feel like they have leadership that supports them, that they need to have flexibility in the way they carry their work out, and that they need to be able to be on a clear and meaningful personal professional development path. And that while compensation is important, compensation does not in the literature feature as the most important thing according to teachers. And so these were among that they need an environment, a physical environment that's safe, that's clean, that's aesthetically appealing, and that's functional. And that if they can get these and other things, that they will have both their motivation and their morale boosted. That they need to have input into their work processes. And these things were borne out in the teacher morale survey. Someone is texting here and ask, how does motivation and morale break down based on conditions of school, location of the school, and behavior of the student body or known gang activity? So I don't have all of the results of the survey with me today. But we will certainly get Ministry of Education's folks to come on and to bring us the detailed results so that you could see how it breaks down in terms of male, female, this school, this the next school, this island, the next island, and so forth, as you ask. I don't know that it'll address all of the questions you have, but it is possible to get some of those, that breakdown. You know what was interesting in doing the literature review was that there were distinctions between the level of morale in the world in terms of teachers between men and women or female and male teachers and what in fact motivated both, so what concerns may have been similar and different for both male and female teachers, right? So we'll be able to talk about some of those when we get the actual data. But thank you for asking that question. It's a very good question. For sure. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. When we come back, we're going to continue our discussions and talk about some of the recommendations that have been made by this Improving Teacher Morale Committee. You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break.
I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody.
Always on the go? Miss the show? You can now listen to Guardian Radio talk shows anytime, anywhere on Spotify and YouTube by searching Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or by entering the name of your favorite show. You can also listen by logging on to guardiantalkradio.com and clicking on the podcast tab. Guardian Radio, continuing to provide you with fresh news and smart talk anywhere, anytime, all day.
Babe, you mash the car?
I ain't mash the car. The lady run into me mash the car.
I hope she had insurance.
If she had insurance, she hop out, pull out her phone, pull up the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang, she was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
Loss of family members is very isolating, and people who have experienced loss appreciate when others have shared their grief. If you can't be there in person, go to the Nassau Guardian's website online at thenassauguardian.com and visit our obituary link. The Nassau Guardian's interactive obituary link allows you to read the funeral announcement, express condolences, or place photos on the online guestbook for one full year. Losing a loved one is painful, but that pain isn't the worst thing to happen. Friends, loved ones, colleagues, and neighbors who ignore the loss compound the pain. Should the bereaved family wish to place the obituary and photos on our obituary site, just contact the Guardian's funeral industry partners or the Nassau Guardian. Remember, there isn't one magic right thing to say to someone experiencing loss that will make the loss less painful or easier to bear. The Nassau Guardian's obituary link, available online at thenassauguardian.com.
Have you taken a look at those investment options yet?
Too busy. Look at today. Workout, breakfast, drop kids at school, back-to-back meetings, dog from the groomer, nails, and that's all before 12. How come you're so chill?
That's because my money is as busy as you.
At RF, we find the best Bahamian and international investments to keep your money busy so you can spend more time focusing on you. Contact us at rfgroup.com to find out more. Our money at work.
I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm. Whatever weather, cold or warm, just let me know that you're not alone. Holla if you feel like you've been down the same road.
Welcome back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Thursday afternoon, where we are talking about, do teachers matter? Do we care about teachers? I mean, like, nobody's really answered the question yet, but I guess you must think, I think it's you must think it's a rhetorical question. The thrust, I think, of the Ministry of Education was essentially that the Minister of Education was to say, yeah, we care. Yeah, teachers really matter. In fact, the research supports that teachers are the single most important factor in the delivery of education in the system. So they matter. Yeah, they matter. That should be obvious, right? Just take them out of the classroom, leave everybody else, and see what happens to education. And I like to hear managers of NBA teams talk about how they're so great and how the management matters and their system matters. Okay, keep your system, keep your managers, keep all your coaches, and then move the players. See how that work out. You can imagine that, producer. You playing basketball and move all the players. Keep the managers, keep the coaches, and see how that goes for the team. They like to say, oh, but we matter the most. We matter. Well, you all matter. You all try and do that without that team. So that's teachers, right? So let's look at the recommendations of the teacher morale committee. What did they recommend? So what the teacher morale committee did was they broke the recommendations down into short term, meaning these are things we think can be done within 12 months. Medium term, these are things we think can be done between 2 and 3 years. And then these are things we think will take over 3 years to do. So what did they recommend? Fortunately for you and for me, the committee was not long-winded and sought to be very practical and concise. And so here are the recommendations. Short-term recommendations, that there should be a letter of appreciation signed by the Honorable Minister sent to all teachers. That was done already. That within 12 months, vouchers of a minimum of $250 should be issued to all teachers at the end of July to assist them with items to improve the physical environment of their classrooms. You all hear that? So by the end of July, all teachers should receive a minimum of $250 that they could use to assist them in improving the physical environment of their schools, of their classrooms. All teachers, every teacher. That's the first, that's the second recommendation, short-term recommendation. The third recommendation was to invite teachers to submit proposals of specific courses / training for professional development. So within the next 12 months, send out an invite and say to teachers, tell me what courses or training you would like to undertake for your own professional development. Wow. Fourth, provide teachers with a specific online portal to submit interests, suggestions, or concerns to the department / Ministry of Education and or Minister of Education. Their own portal. So this ain't for the public. This ain't for parents. This is not for students. This is for teachers. This is teachers' direct input to the Department of Education, the Ministry of Education, the Minister of Education about their interests, suggestions, or concerns. Five, provide digital means of requesting certain documents from the Ministry of Education and Technical and Vocational Training. Example, job letters, references, because teachers complain that it takes too long for them to get these simple things that they require, either for making an application for financial this or that and the next thing. So they want a online digital means by which they put in the request and boom, they can get those documents that they require in short order. Six, provide a staff order of these recommendations at the end of 12 months. So at the end of 12 months, commencing this month, in December, there should be a report saying, as to these recommendations, this, and that has been done. And then aim to ensure that the teacher working and student learning environment is safe, comfortable, aesthetically pleasing, and well-maintained. Safe, comfortable, aesthetically pleasing, and well-maintained. So the implementation committee has to go ahead and try to get those things done within the next 12 months, okay? Medium-term recommendations. Double increments for high-performing teachers. Naturally, somebody will ask, well, who's a high-performing teacher? Well, that is a determination that will have to be made, but they'll get a double increment. Create and, mind you, remember, these have been all cabinet-approved, these recommendations. Create and substantially populate a professional development line item for teachers, if not presently the case, and fund this line item on a per capita cost basis up to a minimum of $2,000. In other words, if there are 5,000 teachers in the system, a minimum of $5 million in a line item called professional development of teachers have to be created in the budget. So if the government, and the government has agreed this, then you should see in the May budget, you should see a line item for that amount so that each teacher essentially will have allocated a minimum of $2,000 this is how it works out on an average when you talk about per capita. But that doesn't mean every teacher will use it, but it will be available for the use of teachers for their professional development. This doesn't have to happen in May because this is 2 to 3 years. I'm sorry. This could happen over the next 2 to 3 years. So the government may decide to populate it on an annual basis over time until it reaches that place, right? Media highlights of teachers. Criteria to be decided. Because one of the things that is indicated in the literature, and teachers also indicated, was the way the education system and teachers and others are portrayed. that maybe there's a place for highlighting the work of teachers in a better and more positive way. Create a teacher's voice talk show to give teachers a forum to discuss their profession, student learning, parental involvement, challenges and career opportunities for young people in education. In pursuit, this is another recommendation, in pursuit of specific projects for student and teacher development, Ministry of Education should facilitate partnerships between schools and corporate Bahamas. So if a school identifies a project, Ministry of Education comes in and says, okay, we are going to help you find a private partner who could work with you to get that project done. So you get the help of the ministry, the force of the ministry behind the school. Create a program for teacher empowerment within the classroom and education sector by giving them more control of curriculum and instruction while connecting performance to promotion. Wow. Whew. Okay, all right, teacher. You now have more control over what you teach. You now have more control over how you teach. But you are also going to have connected to your control performance-related monitoring for promotion. To enhance professional development, the Ministry of Education should partner with the business community to develop a workforce readiness program that would enable teachers to be placed in specific industries relevant to their specialty and discipline. That way you connect the teacher work of teaching with the with what they're teaching for, which is a student employable in that area, right? Or by employable, you mean working on a job or doing business in that area. Strengthen the human resource function related to teacher performance appraisals, right? So teachers don't feel very satisfied with how they are appraised. And so get that fixed. Engage additional teacher aides to assist teachers where needed. That's clear. Create a program to ensure a cap on teacher-student ratio at agreed-upon, evidence-based, optimal level over a designated period of time. And provide a status report on these recommendations at the end of each year. At the end of each year. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to, those are the short term, the 2 to 3 year implements. And then when we come back from the news break, I'll tell you what the long term, 3 years or more recommendations are. You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break.
Take a stand, everybody, everybody. Come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together.
Whether your business is in store, on the go, or both, let Fidelity work with you to maximize your customers' payment options with a fixed or mobile terminal so that you never miss a sale. It's safer than cash and more convenient so that you can take your business anywhere. For details, contact a business development officer today at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport or visit our website at fidelitygroup.com.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
Always on the go? Missed the show? You can now listen to Guardian Radio talk shows anytime, anywhere on Spotify and YouTube by searching Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or by entering the name of your favorite show. You can also listen by logging on to guardiantalkradio.com and clicking on the podcast tab. Guardian Radio, continuing to provide you with fresh news and smart talk anywhere, anytime, all day.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
I'm not afraid to take a stand.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM on this beautiful Thursday afternoon, where we've been talking about teachers and whether they matter or not, whether we care about them or not, because the Ministry of Education launched a program to try and get at the heart of this question and to try and determine what needed to be done in order to boost teacher motivation and teacher morale. And so I was reading from the teacher morale committee's report. I was reading for you the recommendations from that committee to the government about what they thought needed to be done, and this was based on their discussions, based on their literature review, and then based on responses from teachers themselves about what it is that they felt needed to happen for them to be more motivated and more and have higher morale in their profession. And the evidence from them is that they are already motivated and that their morale is high, but that they clearly want to have some stuff done specific to them to get that done. So I read the short term recommendations, the things that the teachers, the committee felt could be done and should be done within 12-month span. I read for you the medium-term recommendations, things that they felt could be done within 2 to 3 years. And I'm now going to read for you the recommendations regarding the long-term, things that might take more than 3 years. Again, I want you to bear in mind that these recommendations were reviewed by the Cabinet of the Bahamas and have been agreed by the Cabinet of the Bahamas, right? So here's the long terms. There aren't many. There aren't many. There's just two. And this committee wasn't trying to impress anybody with long lists. This was, they're trying to do the things what they felt could be done. And so this is the first committee, the first recommendation that they believe should be pursued and achieved in 3 years or more, right? Says, aim to put within a stated period of time teacher salaries on par with professional classes within the public service, meaning a teacher's pay should be on par with an engineer, a doctor, lawyer, etc., within the public service. If you are a teacher in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas, in the public education system, if this comes about, your pay will be on par with any lawyer, any doctor, any engineer within the public service. All right. In tandem, though, with attainment of equivalent certification within the teaching profession, and or aim to ensure that teacher salaries are never outpaced by inflation and never drop to below 80% of some private sector standard. That's the recommendation. And then the final was increased budget allocation for in-service training awards. Increase the budget allocation for in-service training awards. Those are the recommendations. You've heard them. Tell me what you think. What are your thoughts on what you have heard? What are your thoughts? I'm happy to hear them. So, by the way, those of you who sent me the request for the books, we're putting them together. I'll let you know when you can, if you're in Nassau, when you can come and collect them from Guardian Radio. And then I'll let those of you in Grand Bahama know how you could collect yours. If you are somewhere else, we'll have to decide how best to get you yours. Okay? But we definitely will work on that for you. All right. So this text says, good day, Mr. Laing. And yes, teachers matter, especially in the public school system. They encourage each of us to strive for excellence. Look at where you are now. Oh, yeah. Let me say, and any of you who have heard me will know, I firmly believe that my my opportunities in this world have been largely the result of the work of teachers in my life. And so I thank you. I'm with you on that. Check out a Mrs. Petty, Mrs. Cumberbatch, Mrs. Darvill, and Mrs. Williams, just to name a few. You know who you are, and we appreciate you. Yes, absolutely. Thank you very much for that. We appreciate that. This text says, in most large companies, operations and headquarters seem to always be fighting. They barely get along. This is the same thing in the teachers and Ministry of Education headquarters fighting. For some reason, operations and headquarters scuffle beyond its measure, and most times it's more of a power grab rather than teamwork. Okay, well, hopefully that'll not be the case for too long, okay? Or if it is the case. Let's see, we have some. Text. Yeah, this text says, great show as usual, Mr. Laing. I think teachers need some form of protection other than the police against attacks from parents. Okay, so what other kinds of protection could a teacher get from police? From parents other than police or security guard? Like what are you recommending? Says, because these parents becoming more violent against teachers, I ain't no teacher, so I don't have no horse in the race. So Laing, teachers normally work because they love teaching, not because of money. So if they raise the teacher pay, they might just be in it for the money. That's what you think? So if you love something and people pay you better for the something, your view is that they will turn around and only work for the money in it? Really? So anything that you reward people for, they're going to turn around and only work for the reward, even though I don't believe that at all. Can you imagine? If you love basketball, if you play, listen to me. But a producer, you could imagine somebody paying me to play basketball and because they pay me more money, I only can play basketball because they paid me more money? No. If you love basketball, if you love baseball, if you love football, if you love music, if you love something, you can do it because you love it. You love it, right? And I think that teachers who love to teach will continue to love to teach, and getting paid more would just make them happier. In fact, they say that passion is something that you would do all day, every day, for free, but getting paid for it is a great bonus. This text says, with all these incentives you mentioned, we should ask if that will change the D-average and not if they are appreciated. No outcome, no reward. First of all, I understand your point, but here's what is true. We know already that the research supports this. Poorly motivated teachers produce less. Okay? So let's begin there. All right? So you have to do that, and then you have to do the other thing. So no, you're right to point out that it's not just a matter of rewards, but that has to happen too. And then you have to do the other things, like the factors that are affecting learning outcomes. So one of those factors might be poor teacher preparation and that kind of stuff. And so you have to address that too. So you don't do the one and leave the others undone. So, and this is one of the things that happens to us, is we have these isolated one-off things that we think is the bullet, silver bullet. Nothing is a silver bullet. The research says it's a complex issue, so you have to come at it from many angles. We're just discussing one angle today. And we discussed earlier another angle being approached by the Government and Public Policy Institute on behalf of the Ministry of Education. Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you. Oh. Okay, we lost them. If you want to call back, please call back. So nothing is simple. Nothing is one-off. Nothing is the only thing. But you have to do many things. So we don't, if just because I talk about encouraging my child by rewarding him for doing good work, doesn't mean, I don't at the same time mean that I have to discipline him, that I have to teach him how to do certain things and so forth and so forth. So it's never just one thing. So thank you for pointing that out. So what apparently now happens is that the implementation committee, chaired by why did I just register blank? Archdeacon by Palacios. not father. She will chair the implementation committee, and she was a lead player on the review committee. And so she will, and others, I'm on that committee as well, will see about the measures to be taken to actually implement the recommendations. And this is one of the things, the suggestions that's made about implementing recommendations, is that it's good to have people who have been a part of forming those recommendations to actually be a part of implementing the recommendations. So it's the hard work of Reverend Angela Palacios and her team, included on the team are all of the heads of the major unions in the teaching profession, whether it's the management union or the union led by Belinda Wilson or the union led by Mrs. Major. All three of them are on that implementation committee. So they get to play a part in this exercise of trying to bring about these positive results for teachers in the profession. This text says, please inform the previous text that the D average is not a problem that only falls at the feet of teachers. The D average is a national issue and everyone plays a role, teachers, schools, parents, etc. You're absolutely right about that. But it is to me even not a problem for other reasons than that, but I'm just going to leave that right here today. This text says, good day, Mr. Laing. Please dedicate your show tomorrow with songs for the love of teachers. Just an idea. Pre-Valentine's Day to show appreciation. Okay. Okay. I'll see. That sounds like a good idea. We'll see what happens. This text says, please remember guidance counselors. We also giving our all. We deal with the hurting child, happy child, under fair child, and contented child. We are their biggest fans, cheerleading them on when they accomplish milestones. Please mention us. Actually, that was one of the discussions in the committee, was whether we should say teachers or educators, or we should just, you know, because, and guidance counselors are also included in that mix, okay? So I don't think that there is a leaving yourselves out, but there was the determination to specifically look at teachers in this instance, but not to overlook others who play a role in that regard. And certainly guidance counselors are very important in that respect. And I personally know that to be the case because of my own experience in high school. This text says, I would like to change my statement. I texted, teachers really get paid like crap for the job. They do. I drove my teacher crazy when I was in school. They need a fair pay. Okay. All right, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll continue our discussion. We'll be back after this break.
I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid to take a stand. Take a stand. Everybody, everybody, take my hand. Come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm. Whatever weather, cold or warm. Send you know that you're not a...
Babe, you mashed the car?
I ain't mashed the car. The lady run into me mashed the car.
I hope she had insurance.
If she had insurance, she hop out, pull out her phone, pull up the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang, she was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today, or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
Loss of family members is very isolating, and people who have experienced loss appreciate when others have shared their grief. If you can't be there in person, go to the Nassau Guardian's website online at thenassauguardian.com and visit our obituary link. The Nassau Guardian's interactive obituary link allows you to read the funeral announcement, express condolences, or place photos on the online guestbook for one full year. Losing a loved one is painful, but that pain isn't the worst thing to happen. Friends, loved ones, colleagues, and neighbors who ignore the loss compound the pain. Should the bereaved family wish to place the obituary and photos on our obituary site, just contact the Guardian's funeral industry partners or the Nassau Guardian. Remember, there isn't one magic right thing to say to someone experiencing loss that will make the loss less painful or easier to bear. The Nassau Guardian's obituary link, available online at thenassauguardian.com.
So much going on in the world today, only accepting cash at your business can be risky. Let Fidelity offer you and your customers safety, convenience, and the flexibility of a fixed or mobile terminal. Take it with you, on the move and on the go, because business should never stop. For more details, speak to one of our business development officers at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676-PORT. Visit our website at fidelitygroup.com or visit us at any of our branches.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
Sarah, how are you doing?
Okay.
Are you sure? I noticed you've been down lately.
Yeah, sometimes I don't know. I can't really put into words how I'm feeling, but I know I don't feel like myself sometimes. There's just so much going on in my life. School, friends, sports. Sometimes I worry about different things and feel stressed.
I'm glad you're talking to me. And it's okay to talk about your feeling. It's normal to feel changes depending upon what's going on around you.
Yeah?
Of course. All of us should be concerned with our mental health and our well-being. Good mental health means that we can cope with our everyday stresses. You can talk to me anytime when you feel like it.
Okay. Make sure that they check and talk more often and take things from there.
Message is brought to you by PAHO WHO and the Ministry of Health and Wellness.
Have you taken a look at those investment options yet?
Too busy. Look at today. Workout, breakfast, drop kids at school, back-to-back meetings, dog from the groomer, nails, and that's all before 12. How come you're so chill?
That's because my money is as busy as you.
At RF, we find the best Bahamian and international investments to keep your money busy so you can spend more time focusing on you. Contact us at rfgroup.com to find out more. RF, money at work.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Let me know that you're not alone. Holla if you feel like you've been down the same road.
Welcome back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad that you could join us here today on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, on this beautiful Thursday afternoon. If you want to give us a call, the numbers are 323-6232 or 325-4316 or 325-4259. You can text us on 422-4796 or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. I have a text here that says, good day, I'm a teacher listening in. I cannot believe all of the negative comments that I hear from my fellow Bahamians. Teaching is a thankless profession with very little monetary rewards. Try teaching up to 300 different ages, I think. Teenagers a day, and see how long you will last. We have bachelor's, master's, and even doctorate degrees. We put the investment into our education. We should be compensated adequately for it. Stop the hateful nonsense. I didn't hear a lot of people actually utter negativity toward your pay. One person, and they came back and fixed that. One person said they made a comment. So far you know not too many people said some positive, but not one person really, maybe two. wasn't too bad. But I understand, passionate about your profession. And the truth is, let's be honest about some stuff, right? Generally speaking, my observation is Bahamians have an awful view of the public education system in the Bahamas. Awful. Generally speaking. I mean, that disclosure by the Ministry of Education on an annual basis about the grades just does education in. Now, get mad with me. What's new? Most people who talk about this D grade, let me say this to y'all. And I you know what? I'm going to be very respectful and I'm going to be calm. Those of you who continue to push and shove this D grade in front of people like it's such a horrible thing, you simply do not understand the grading system in the Bahamas. You can text me and you can say to me, Zhivargo, I don't care what you say, a D is a D and that's terrible. You could tell me that till the cows come home. You are wrong. You do not understand education. You do not understand learning. You do not understand our system. You do not understand human development. I want to say it again. Get mad with me. Get angry with me. I understand. You don't like being told you're wrong. And on this score, I will take second fiddle to no one. Not because I'm an expert on education, but because from the experts in education, I understand this. If you, a Bahamian or non-Bahamian, with money, without money, with a business, without business, with education, without education. If you're white or black, if you're a politician or pastor, I really do not care about that. If you keep shoving a D grade as the standard of why our education system is or is not what it is, you do not understand, do not know, do not know, do not understand learning, education, the system of learning, the system of grading in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. And let me also say, you do not think deeply about learning or education or our system in too many ways, because many of you in your higher echelon in the country, presidents, managers, general managers, directors, supervisors, etc., and many of you who work for these people, never accomplished, never achieved, on average in your schooling, better than a C, maybe most, many of you, better than a D, and did not do so. And if you had to take right now a GCE, you yourself had to take a GCE, you wouldn't get maybe a D grade. You say, but Zhivargo, I'm not studying that now. What difference does it make? If you learned the stuff, if that's what it's about, if you learned the stuff, then you should be able to recount the stuff. That's what learning is. But you can't. I couldn't without some more further study, right? So does getting the grade really say what you know? Is that is it saying in many, many instances what you can recount? But what we know is you having now maybe unable to get a C in math, a C in English, in a C in geography, and all these kinds of things, chemistry, physics, etc. Can't get it. Right now, today, we know that you are very capable in law, if you are a lawyer, very capable in accounting, if you're an accountant, very capable in economics, if you're an economist, very capable in banking, if you're a banker, very capable in electrical, if you're an electrician, and so forth and so forth. Why? Because your many years of exposure and work in that area helped you to develop a repetitive skill that you can now apply. And so can these same children who you spend so much time blasting for some fictitious, non-knowledgeable awareness of the grading system, learning system in the Bahamas. And it has for years sickened me. Your comment, your notions about it sickened me. And I spent a show years ago talking about this, and I got a call from a prominent managing director of a bank in the Commonwealth of Bank, a prominent bank in the Bahamas. And he said, Zhivargo, I have to tell you, before I listened to your show, I thought the way many of the people thought that you were criticizing for the way they see this D grade and the grades. He said, I changed my mind because I now better understand what it is. And it doesn't matter to me that if you get it or don't get it, because it's irrelevant. Because what matters is those children, when they come out of school, whatever that grade is they have, it will tell an employer what they can do. That's what the grade will tell the employer, if the employer is ready to listen. And yes, what is true. Whether they come out with a D grade, C grade, B grade, or A grade, the employers of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas still have to assess, hire, and train them to do their work. And that work is not taught in the schools. Let me repeat it. There's a producer producing this show today. He ain't sitting in no high school in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas learning how to produce. Is that true or not true, producer? But he's producing today. Capably producing today. The journalist here, they learned English. and other skills required for it. But that journalism that they're doing, this company has to put them in the line to learn and pick up that skill effectively and efficiently for them. Because that's what learning is. Learning is learning how to learn in whatever environment you are placed. We've got lawyers in the country who passed the bar. Do you know whether their grades were? You think all of them got A's, B's, or whatever? Or you think all of them, none of them barely passed the bar? But would you know? You wouldn't know. You wouldn't know. How would you know? The doctors. In whose hands you put your life. What grades did they get? Do you know? Did they ever tell you? Is any of them prepared to just lay out their transcripts to you? Why? They still know how to tell you, you have tuberculosis. You need to take these particular antibiotics for a year. You need to have first instance be in isolation for two years. They know how to diagnose you. You need a Mantoux test. If the Mantoux test is positive, they'll tell you you need to have an X-ray done. They'll read the X-ray and they'll see what the X-ray reveals and so forth. And then they know how to prescribe necessary solutions to your problem. I know that. Now, I know that. And I'm not a doctor. And I can't write prescriptions. No, y'all could hate on me, get mad at me, get vexed at me. I'm sorry. Y'all, you can never have me on board with your continuous, very shallow, very simplistic understanding of the grading system of our BGCSE in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. I cannot get on board with you on that. So do I walk around ashamed and quote that we have an average, D average in the Bahamas? Absolutely not. Because we don't have no D average in the Bahamas. That's something y'all ignorantly say. Some of you, not all of you, some of you. That's what you say. That's what your unawareness tells you. I don't say that. And even if the average was D, what it tells me is the average student in the Bahamas can, in that subject area, math or English, perform at this level of math. And I can almost guarantee you, it's probably a higher level of math than most of you in the population can perform at right now today if called upon to do so. How do I know that? I have a master's degree. And my son does math. He's in 9th grade. Yeah, get mad with me. I'm talking about my son and my family. No problem. You don't want to listen? Turn your TV off. But my son does a math. And sometimes when he does a problem, but occurring, I got to go and check the book to learn how to do the thing again. I got a master's degree. So he knows manipulations of math that I have to re-educate myself in today. That's why some of you are not smarter in math today than the D students you criticize. I'm trying to help us today. That's what I'm trying to do. Right? And I'm just trying to help us. Understand, I'm not asking you to be satisfied with a D grade. I'm not. I really am not. If we have all of our students could get A, that's brilliant. That's beautiful. We should strive and aim for that. I'm just trying to help us understand it better so that we can talk about it more intelligently. That's all I'm trying to do, okay? So good afternoon again, Mr. Laing. The issue is not everyone is willing to take accountability for the role they play. The role they play in the average being what it is. Lastly, I wholeheartedly agree that the public does not understand the fundamentals about the grading system. The comment of the D average is always poorly placed in conversation. Ask the public if they are aware that the grading system has in fact changed. The comments are laughable because the actual issue is that we lack critical thinking skills, even as adults. And this is what the D average is a reflection of. I agree with you 100%, and you're an educator, 100%. This text says, so rewards and remuneration should be based on qualification and meritocracy, not to mention success rate of their students. Teaching is one of those professions still that is a calling, not necessarily a profession to be in to get rich. We have to be careful not rewarding. There is no progress. An AD average is not progress. Let's get with it. Stop making excuses. No, you are not about making excuses. You are just not informed. You, I don't care how string words together, you do not understand. You have never tried to understand. You couldn't tell me one lick about our grading system because you don't know. You simply don't know. And I'm not going to get on board with you. I'm not going to support you in it because you simply, by your words, don't know. When you use, first of all, I'm going to ask you, you're brilliant. You think you're brilliant. You know how it works. You know what should be done. What D average do we have? Please tell me. Tell me what does that mean, that the Bahamas has a D average? Please, somebody who thinks that, tell me what that means. I guarantee you, not a single one of you can accurately tell me what that means. Not one who say it. Tell me what that means. That the Bahamas has a D average. Tell me what that means. Today, please, somebody tell me. Go ahead. We're going to take a break. I'm going to give you time to tell me what that means. We have a D average. Show me it. Show me the evidence of it. You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break.
Everybody, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm.
Girl, you see how Cora eye look funny, all black up yesterday?
But she say she bump into a wall when she's running after the churn them.
Yeah, but last Saturday, you see her arm was all black and blue, right?
What you saying? You think something wrong between her and Jack?
I ain't sure, but you know Jack is a jealous man. I hear him and Cora last Friday. I hear him say he hear Cora have eyes for Junior.
Now, you know that ain't true. Cora is a good woman. Does mind her business, take care of them churn and go to church every Sunday. So what you think we should do?
I think we should report Jack, you know. Cora don't say nothing, but silence hides violence. And we don't want to line up in the cemetery.
Not me. I ain't getting in nobody business. Then Jack come after me and I line up next to Cora.
No, man, we could call a text Crime Stopper. And remember, we can even get some grocery money for our tip.
Remind me again how this work.
We can call them in Miami at 328 tips or 328-8477. Or when we in the island, call toll free at 300 tips or 300-8477. And if you don't have no minutes, use the Crack Crime Bahamas app and we could text them. And the messages get on mix up before it leave your phone. So nobody can know what you're saying.
So what are we waiting on then? Let's go earn some grocery money.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
Whether your business is in store, on the go, or both, let Fidelity work with you to maximize your customers' payment options with a fixed or mobile terminal so that you never miss a sale. It's safer than cash and more convenient so that you can take your business anywhere. For details, contact a business development officer today at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport or visit our website at fidelitygroup.com.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
Always on the go? Missed the show? You can now listen to Guardian Radio talk shows anytime, anywhere on Spotify and YouTube by searching Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or by entering the name of your favorite show. You can also listen by logging on to guardiantalkradio.com and clicking on the podcast tab. Guardian Radio, continuing to provide you with fresh news and smart talk anywhere, anytime, all day.
This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM.
I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. I'm so glad that you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this for these remaining moments of the show. I'm so eager to get to this texter. So this is what the texter says. Remember, I asked, tell me what the average is. Here's what the texter says. This is the answer. I understand the education system. I just have to look around in society. No critical thinking, the crime rate, for example. Not to speak of the drug activities, corrupt everywhere. Corruption everywhere, lack of education. By the way, don't blow a gasket. It's just my opinion. You don't get away that easily. You don't have the luxury of doing that. And I'm not blowing a gasket. I'm passionate about this issue. And I am absolutely unapologetic about my passion for this issue and correcting it as I can. And you don't get to get off because it's your opinion. No, that's not how you stated it. That's not how you stated it. You stated it as a fact. Okay? And you didn't answer my question. Could you imagine if they asked a student, what is Pythagoras' theorem? And they said, well, it's my opinion that. Or they said, I understand that it is, this is happening in our society. That's not an answer. And that's the problem right there. You would get an X. You would get an F. But in your opinion, know what a D average is and the Bohemian society is this, that. You know but all the corrupt people, but you don't know but all the other people in this country who are doing all the positive things that allows you to live in a civil society. That is your assessment. You know what? You just demonstrated why we would not be able to rely upon you to advance us in this way. You've just demonstrated that. And so you're demonstrating that D average that you think we have and what it does to the society is an average which you are reflecting in your thinking. Because I'm sorry, you are not critically thinking at the moment. You're not. Okay? And so don't think I'm going to back off because you tell me don't bust a gasket. I'm going to bust one. Because what you are doing is the same thing too many people are doing who are, without knowledge, castigating a system that has produced enormous results for the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. Is it perfect? Does it need help? Does it need improvements? Absolutely, but we're all admitting that. But what we don't want is people like you two, without knowledge, be commenting on a system you do not understand. You do not. And you demonstrated that you don't understand it. You don't, because you couldn't tell me what a D average is. And I asked you, and you didn't tell me. So, Mr. Laing, I don't know who texted you, but I brought the subject up. A student who is awarded a D grade on national examination has satisfied at least 50% of the syllabus requirements for the subject. Absolutely. And you know what the student knows. That's what you know. Now, you can't tell me the country has a D average. Nobody could tell me that because the country doesn't take one exam. You see, how could you have a D average if you take multiple exams? Even if you were trying to say to me you have a D average, you have to say to me, in math, we have a D average. In English, we have a D average. In art, we have a D average. In geography, we have a... You'd have to say that, and then you'd have to pull all of them together and say, okay, well, on all the averages of all the subjects, we have a D average. You'd have to tell me something like that, but you can't tell me that. And a D average in the grade descriptive system we have makes no sense other than to say, on average, the level of competence of our students in this particular subject matter is this. And then you'd have to tell me what a D grade means. They can read and write at this level, do these kinds of things within that subject area. That's what you'd have to tell me. But you don't know that because you never studied it. You never read it. And let me give you a quote. Study to show yourself approved. A workman that need not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. He who answers a matter without hearing it, it is foolishness to him. So don't comment on things you don't understand. Ask questions. It'll be helpful to your discussion and your learning and to your participation and advancement in it. I am not reading a single other thing you write. Because now you are just in your feelings trying to defend yourself. Right? That's all it is. You have demonstrated exactly what I said. You do not understand it. You will never understand it because you're not trying to understand it. You've just formed an opinion, and by stating it is an opinion, you're not even open to learning. So you are not even performing, in quote, at a D level. You are performing below a D level because you are failing the basic rule of knowledge. If you have an opinion, be open to facts. You're failing in that regard. And we are not going to continue to let people like you get away with describing us ignorantly. We're not going to do it. Teachers in this country shouldn't do it, and they shouldn't be ashamed to do it. They shouldn't be ashamed. They should speak up for their system. Even as they advocate for its change, even as they advocate for its improvement, they should speak up for their system and help the non-knowledgeable people in the country understand their system. That's what they should do. Especially people who, if you ask them right now to take any one of those BGCSEs, couldn't pass it. Right this very minute. And not because they're dumb, not because they're unintelligent, not because they're unknowledgeable, but because they would not have been prepared with the content to recall to be able to do that. And they might not have the critical thinking skills that are applied in that exam to do those particular examinations right now today. And they could be presidents, general managers, business owners, very wealthy people in this country, politicians. Many of them couldn't pass them. I could tell you, I could take some of them BGCSEs today and I would not pass some of them. That's a fact. And I sit down doing my son's BJCs with him, preparations. I don't know the answers to them questions, some of them. So I wouldn't be able to pass. But am I dumb? Maybe. Says, thanks for consistently informing me. The D average is average of grade point averages of all students at all grade levels. Could be represented at each grade level or combinations of grade levels. Same done for reading grade levels. Okay. Says, good day. I'm learning something new every day listening to your show. Thank you, my friend. While I blow a gasket. I don't know when some, not many, but when some of our listeners will understand. You can't throw me off my game with innuendos, accusations, and stuff like that. I'm 55 years old, man. I'm so past that nonsense, right? However the tone is, I try to improve it. I try to make sure I don't offend you, etc. But I'm not entirely altogether concerned about that. Listen to what I say. If you disagree with the thought, okay, that's fine. That's no problem. But don't let's get thrown off, man. We are talking about important things. And in talking about important things, sometimes we are impassioned. I hear some of y'all talk about basketball, and you're cussing and carrying on all day. You talk about the Dolphins, and you're cussing and carrying all day. You're loud and shouting, and then you're mad with me when I'm talking about education in an impassioned way. Please. Grow up. We're not going to go down that road. Say, bravo, Mr. Laing, bravo. Thank you for defending the hard work that we as teachers do in preparing our students year after year for these national exams. By the way, teachers have yet to be paid for making the national exams, and it's almost that time again. Wow. Yeah, man, y'all know how to beg me, y'all know how to plead with me. I am with the teachers and the education system. Are y'all perfect? No. Are we perfect? No. Do we need improvement? Absolutely. But my God, what y'all have done for the Commonwealth of the Bahamas over these years, you would have to be an absolute ungrateful, unobserving, dismissal soul to say it wasn't grand. Say, in my opinion, the difference of opinion is often because of the perspective of a person. For example, a 9 can be at 6 depending on where one stands while looking at it. That's true, but in this instance, no. Because in this instance, the education system determined what its grading system is, and the education said was a satisfactory result in that system, and that's what it is. Now, if you don't like it, that's a different story. But this is not a matter of opinion. The grade descriptive was provided by them, just like it was provided by Oxford when they did it. And Oxford did help with the development of our new system. So no, this is not a matter of opinion. It's a matter of fact. The standard determined by our education system. Not you and me. We don't get to run around and go, oh, D is bad because... No, that's not the point. That's like saying the NBA decide what a three-point is. When the person hit a three-point, you say, yeah, but it depends on where you're sitting inside the stands, what a three-point is. No, it depends on what the NBA said is the distance you have to shoot it from in order to have a three-point. That's what the BGCSE result is like. Very same thing. Okay, so I'm sorry, this is not about opinion. Doesn't arise. Ladies and gentlemen, you've been listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. I hope you have a great evening. God bless. We'll talk to you again tomorrow. God spares life.
I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm. Let me know that you're not alone. Holla if you feel like you've been down the same road.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.